So, what the heck is 3D effects doing? You may have seen some articles about this, but in case you haven't been keeping up, there's this account on Twitter, or at least there was, since it's now been deleted, called 3DFX Interactive, that claimed to be the official account for 3DFX. Short answer, no, it wasn't real, it was just a gigantic troll, and I'm here to tell you all about this. Before you ask me in the comments, 3DFX was a big player back in the late 90s in the GPU game, especially for 3D graphics, and it was a third company completely detached from either Nvidia and ATI, doing their own things, but of course still in competition against them, especially with Team Green. Due to delays and problems, the company filed for bankruptcy in 2002, and most of the assets were bought by Nvidia. Now that you have some base knowledge, let's begin. I'll cover everything and every consideration in chronological order, so you can see my thoughts throughout the days. The first post on the account, posted on July 31st, reads as follows. 3DFX Interactive is coming back, 20 years later. Prepare for an major announcement regarding our return this Thursday. First of all, an major? Did nobody proofread this? Secondly, the image used is a community-created one from 2014 from DeviantArt, which is honestly a bit suspicious. Do they not have the money to commission a simple cover art? Then they go on to post another three teasers. One is just a reiteration of the first one, the other one is simply a date, August 5th, and the last one, posted on August 4th, contains some actual information. It reads as follows. Johnson Products is proud to announce that 3DFX is returning after 20 years. Johnson Products, a new investment company in San Francisco, acquired the assets of 3DFX Interactive on July 23rd and is currently in the process of trademarking the 3DFX name. 3DFX is scheduled to return this winter with new graphics card and will expand into other products relating to smartphones, smart TVs and sound systems. Okay, let's stop for a moment and think about this a little more objectively before reading last post, which are an absolute dumpster fire, and taking a look at the Wayback Machine, because yes, somewhere archived all of this. As I told you before, most of the 3DFX assets and intellectual properties was acquired by Nvidia a long time ago. If you go on 3dfx.com, it still redirects you to nvidia.com, and even 3dfxinteractive.com isn't claimed. Furthermore, the actual trademark status for 3DFX or 3DFX Interactive, as stated by the USPTO, United States Patent of Trademark Office, is listed as dead. You'd think a multi-million dollar company would at least secure the trademark before making a public announcement, right? I can't even seem to find an investment company called Johnson Products in the first place. Also, side note, about their name, that seems awfully close to Jensen, which is the name of the CEO of Nvidia. Lastly, who in their right mind will revive such an influential company for GPUs and announce sound systems and f***ing smartphones? Anyway, let's now cover the Twitter thread they posted on August 5th. Not all posts are important, I'll skip the boring ones. If you wanna read them, just pause the video right now. Quote, new items in development. 3DFX is currently working on the following products for CES 2022. They misspelled CES, somehow it's three letter, guys, come on. They even acknowledged this later, but $10 they made it on purpose. Anyway, 3DFX Voodoo 6 PCI. Good luck selling that in 2022. 3DFX Rufon smartphone, Brozzo Bluetooth. Okay, listen, I can take this seriously. Read them if you want. Okay, done? Yes? Perfect. Let's proceed. Next slide. Quote, why expand into other products? See this big text? Don't bother reading. It basically just says yes. Okay, good. Next image. Now I've covered the names for the things. But can you actually guess what the 10% of the pie chart is dedicated to? Of course, GPUs, 10% of all investment, sure. Like any serious company will do that. At this point, it should be pretty obvious that it's an MLG 360 no-scope epic troll of an account, but just in case you're not 100% convinced yet, let's see the Wayback Machine and let's look up some saved snapshots. In a mere week this account existed, it made some short-lasting posts and modifications to the bio, especially in the last moments of the account. Most notably, parody account, in brackets, in the bio, and Also, the people who are angry with me are the same ones who can't take a simple joke, or others that you can see on the screen right now. It also seems like they fooled a lot of people with this account, since they managed to get almost 6,000 followers before deleting the profile. Well guys, this is all I had to say today. Sorry for not being in the usual 3D VR model, but my Oculus Rift decided that this was an optimal period to commit harakiri permanently, so I don't have a VR anymore for the time being. Thankfully, my friend Memma gave me some nice drawings to use instead of my avatar for a little while, so to thank her, I leave her Instagram account in the description. Comment, like, subscribe if you want, and I'll see you again in the next video.